Ask Molly's. You have to admit, this looks like a delicious portion of rice, vegetables and spices. But this is also known as insect caviar. This dish is made of the edible larvae and pupae of ants, harvested from the tequila or agave plant. Considered something of a delicacy, they taste buttery and nutty, with a texture like a cottage cheese. This mouth-watering delicacy is most commonly consumed in Mexico City since the age of the Aztecs. Jacal. The rotting carcass of a Greenland or basking shark. It's buried underground in a shallow pit and pressed with stones or simply left to rot. So the poisonous internal fluids that allow shark to live in such cold waters can be drained out and making the meat safe to eat. Otherwise, they can make you seriously ill or even kill you. After this, it's hung out to dry before being cut into stripes and served. With a smell that described as ammonia-rich and a strong fishy flavor, it was described as the single worst, most disgusting and terrible tasting thing. Surströmming. Baltic Sea herring fermented with just enough salt used to prevent it from rotting. This is a traditional Swedish delicacy since at least the 16th century. Mainly found canned in brine these days, when opened it releases such a disgusting aroma that it usually needs to be eaten outside. Okay, sounds delightful. Sanagji. Another one that ranks high on the cruelty scale. It consists of nagi, a small octopus that has been cut into small pieces while still alive and served immediately, usually lightly seasoned with sesame and sesame oil. The nagi pieces are usually still wriggling on the plate when served. We can take solace that sometimes the tentacles get revenge and choke the consumer. So it's pretty even after that, isn't it? Rocky Mountain Oysters. Despite the name, these aren't actually oysters at all. No, they are bull testicles fried deep in a batter of flour, pepper and salt. Why would anyone even eat this? Well, it's done for breeding purposes rather than specifically for culinary reasons. We are happy we can find a use for a part of the animal that would otherwise be wasted. What a happy ending! Kauppi Luwak. Wouldn't be awesome if we could afford a cup of most expensive coffee on the world every single morning? The most expensive coffee comes not harvested by human hands, but the stomach of a wild beast named civet. It eats only the best grains of coffee and then the process of getting this expensive coffee begins. The civet gastric juices literally massage these coffee beans, removing their sharp edges, part of caffeine and proteins that made coffee bitter and unpleasant for consuming. After that, it is necessary to wait for this animal to unload the grains in order to prepare them for further processing. The resulting grains are greenish-brown after dried in the sun and a good scrubbing, dozens of times at least we hope so, it's ready for roasting and grinding. Casu Marzu, also known as maggot cheese. This traditional Sardinian dish is sheep's milk cheese famous for containing live insect larvae. Apparently, these wiggling little maggots are supposed to enhance the flavor, but are prone to jump when they panic. So watch your eyes and try not to chase them around the room. Some people suffocate them or kill the beasties in the fridge before consuming, but others go for the live version. Sometimes they survive the stomach and burrow into your intestines. Tuna eyeball. There's nothing like eating something while it's staring directly at you. Tuna eyeball can be found in most Japanese stores for about a dollar. Apparently, it tastes a bit like a squid and the eyeball comes surrounded by fish fat and severed muscles that are also meant to be quite tasty. To prepare it, you simply boil it and then season to taste. Century egg. This egg is pretty rotten. After being preserved in a mixture of clay, ash and quicklime for a few months, the yolk turns to a dark green or even black and slimy, while the white has turned to a dark brown, translucent jelly. Apparently, it smells very much like a sulfur and ammonia, but tastes like a hard-boiled egg. Mmm, egg-tastic! Balut. When served, it looks like an innocent hard-boiled egg. It's only like that when you realize it's actually developing bird embryo, usually a duck or chicken, all together with tiny bones, feathers and beak, all soft-boiled whole inside the shell. It is a street food available in Vietnam and Philippines, and it is an ethnic delicacy. It is a fertilized egg, incubated or allowed to grow for a few weeks. This is done in a warmth of the sunlight, and the egg is held up against the light to check if it's ready to be served. The right way to enjoy it is to slurp it from the shell with a pinch of salt and squirts of a lemon juice.